观众朋友们，欢迎收看 Urban TV， 我们说汉语，我是阿老师或者阿波罗老师。Hello, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Urban TV. My name is Apollo, and we're live with our program, Let's Talk Chinese. So get ready with your pen and paper for the show. And this is our dear, lovely teacher.
Okay, everyone, good evening. Nice to see you again. Welcome to Urban TV. Let's Talk Chinese. My name is Wang Xiaojuan. 我叫王小娟。So, I think all of you are excited to get to know the winners.From last week, so let's get to the first one. The question was, 您喜欢喝什么? And we had a lot of callers. One of the best is...
Ike or Eric Mutawe.
Okay, congratulations. You will be one of our participants to join our final event after our show is finished. The second question was,Why 喝 has 口 as the radical?We had a lot of comments. I chose three of them to be here. The first one...
Shamila Abdallah?
Yeah, the answer is 喝 has 口 as the radical because it has part of the character that indicates the many drink with the mouth. I think this is pretty correct, right?
Mm-hmm.
The second one is from...
Clovis Virunji.
Yeah, the answer is because ko represents mouth and he has a relation to mouth, meaning to drink.
Yes.
Yeah, similar meaning, so I think both of the answers are correct. The last one is 因为喝东西需要用口 Okay, I think this is our...best answer.
It's our best answer, but it happens, Ms. Wang, you have to make a quick judgment now. Happens to be that Mutawa Eric is the same winner who answered the question, the phone call.
Yes.
Tashi Aike. So the answer goes to?
This one.
Clovis Birunji, right?
Yes.
Clovis Birunji, you are our lucky winner, Clovis Birunji. And Mutawa Eric, thank you for being enthusiastic. You cannot win twice. You can only win on...phone call, you called. So, Clovis Birunji, you are our lucky winner on Twitter.
Congratulations, yes. Clovis. You'll also get a present from us, and you will also be one of our participants after the show is finished.
Okay,
the third question was, how do you say 50,000?
Yes, 50,000.
And the first one is from Ashraf
Junior.
Junior?
Ashraf Junior?
The answer is... What?
Yes.
So
interesting.
This one has a tiny mistake because he tried to type 15,000 in Chinese. But you know, we have a lot of characters with similar or same pronunciations. So it's very easy to type wrong characters if you only know the pronunciation. That is why we require everyone to start.To learn how to write Chinese, how to recognize Chinese characters.
Yes.
And the second answer is from...
Mbabazi, Liberty.
Yeah, the answer is Wan. But as you can see, the characters are chicken.
Yes.
That's because this one he gave is actually traditional Chinese characters. We have traditional Chinese characters and simplified...Chinese characters. Traditional ones are more complicated. That is why we simplified all of the characters in order to help everyone to memorize more easily.
Yes.
The last one is
Oscar
from,
Niwagawa.
Yeah, this is our best answer. 50,000.
So, congratulations to Oscar Niwagawa. But I would also like to congratulate Ashraf Jr. for being a constant viewer and very active on Facebook.And Twitter. We also thank you, Mbawazi Liberty, for being a very wonderful viewer and participating in the questions. Remember, the phone call is 0414-337-872. 0414-337-872. That's the number you can call. And remember, when you're calling, keep away from your TV or reduce the volume so that we can be able to hear you very well. And also, those who are ready to answer the questions, remember, follow Urban TV on Facebook and Twitter. And remember, we are sponsored by Macquarie University Confucius Institute. So if you want to learn more, Miss Wang and myself, you can always meet us at Macquarie University Confucius Institute.
Okay, so since you already know the number,
yes.
And we're announcing the questions for this week. The first one is, 您喜欢
喝什么？
喝什么？The second one is, this is actually the questions from last week. We are announcing this one because this is also related to the questions for today. As you can see, how do you say 50,000? I'm pretty sure you will get something similar to that one from this week. So the first question for this week is, how do you say, I want to buy mooncake? Okay, that's already something you can remember. This one will be for the callers.
Okay.
And the second question is, how do you say 90,000? This one is on Facebook, as I mentioned a minute before. This is related to something we studied last week. The third question is how the character Yue was created. And we will explain in the following content. So please keep watching our show. And same as usual, we will review something from last week. The phrases. The first one, 果汁 juice. 火龙果 dragon fruit. 可乐 coke. 牛奶 milk. 喝 drink. 百 hundred. 万 10,000. 先令 shilling. Okay, we review again here. If you want to say numbers like 30,000. We use 4 digits as a unit, which represents 10,000 in Chinese. You only use one character once. So you only put 3 with 1 together, that's already 30,000.
Okay.
And next one, the character we studied last time, which
火.
Is 火. So as you can see the picture here, it looks like the character itself, firewood with flames. And we have 4 strokes for the character. The first one, 点 then 撇,
okay,
撇, then 撇, the longer 撇, then 那 this is
点 撇,
yeah. This is the character 火. I hope everyone is practicing writing with us. And we also studied a character, more complicated one, 喝, which has a radical of mouth.
Yes.
This radical is to indicate the meaning of the character 喝, drink, to drink with our mouth. This is 喝, to
喝,
drink. Okay, then the conversation, the dialogues we had last time. We can start from the first sentence. 您的爱好是什么?
我喜欢打网球。那是什么?
那是果汁。火龙果汁多少钱? 一万先令。可乐多少钱? 900先令。您想喝什么?
我喝可乐。您想喝什么?
我喝可乐。 Then 900先令, 500, you only need to put the number before it. Okay, we will remind you of the questions again. The first one, how do you say, I want to buy mooncake? The second one, how do you say,
90,000.
The third one,
How was the character Yue created? How was the character Yue created?
Yes. Okay. Then For today's new content, I think we have to start with our pronunciation, initials and finals. We can start with that group. ER. It's pronounced something like
R.
Yes.
Okay.
R. R. Mm. You put your tongue up.
R.
Mm. Yes. R. Then next one, IN. Mm. IN.
Okay.
Next one, IN.
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 Okay.
IN. And this one? This one? Next one.
Okay.
Yeah. Oui. That is similar to the last one. So it's pronounced we.
We. The one on dui.
Yes. We. So you'll find a way to differentiate similar pronunciations.
We. Hui.
Hui. Okay. Yes. We will study a lot of characters with this kind of initial and final. Then let's get back to the tonal marks.
Yes.
Tonal marks. I think this is pretty hard for everyone, so we practice again and again. The first group is the first tone.
Bao.
Bao.
Qiu.
Qiu.
Duan.
Duan.
Tiao.
Tiao.
Jie.
Jie. Mai. Bing. Wu. Mian.
Mian.
Yue.
Yue.
Zong.
Zong.
Then the last one, neutral tone, soft and short. Z.
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 Okay, we put them together to form some new phrases. The first one, 买.
买.
To buy.
Yes.
买.
买.
面条.
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 Noodle. 面包.
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 Bread. So, as you can see, we have two same characters for these two phrases. The character 面, actually it means wheat powder.
Yes, wheat flour. Wheat flour. In Uganda we call it wheat flour.
Okay, next one. 月.
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 It means moon.
Yes, yes.
And please look at it very carefully and you'll find something interesting out of the character itself, the image.
Yes.
月饼.
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 Mooncake. 中秋节.
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 Mid-autumn festival. Mid-autumn festival. And I think this can remind you of the character 中 again. We studied before. 中, 中国. China, middle country. 中 means middle.
Yes.
Next one. 粽子.
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 Chinese rice dumpling.
Yes.
Next one. 端午节.
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 Dragon boat festival. And as you can see here, these two phrases also have some one common character, the last one, 节, 节, which means festival, festival. And since we are talking about festivals here, so we will briefly introduce two important festivals in China. The first one, of course, it's 中秋节, 中秋节, mid-autumn festival, mid-autumn festival, as you can see here. This is a moon. This is mooncake, which represent the festival itself.
Yes.
Mid-autumn festival. Usually it falls on the 15th day of the 8th month in Chinese calendar. So we celebrate this festival because it has a full moon on that day. So it represents family reunion.
Yes.
People go back home from different kinds of places to enjoy a dinner together.
And it is, briefly, it is 团团圆圆.
Yes.
Yes, okay.
It's also the same for the mooncakes. As you can see, it's round. It looks like a moon.
Yes.
It represents family reunion. Family reunion.
Togetherness. Family.
Yes. And next one, 端午节, Dragon Boat Festival, 端午节, and 粽子, Chinese rice dumpling.
Yeah,
this one is super important because we celebrated here with a lot of Ugandans. We talked about last week, we had a Dragon Boat race.
Festival, yes.
Joined by a lot of Ugandan teams and Chinese teams. So it's like something we have to mention here.
Yes, it's even, it was even in the newspaper, even on our media stations, like Phuket, they were showing people dragon boat racing. Yes.
Yeah, it's interesting. And we'll have to talk about the origin of the festival. It's about people remembering a very important poet, patriotic actually.
Yeah.
He drowned himself after his country was invaded because he couldn't do anything to save the country or to save the people from suffering.
Yes.
So he drowned himself and people loved him so much. So people were afraid of his body being eaten by fish or other kinds of creatures in a river. So people usually throw dumplings or rice products to the river to save his body from being eaten by fish. Yeah, that's why we eat Chinese rice dumpling now to also to commemorate this kind of great people.
Yes.
And finally, we come to this part. This is a character. Yue.
Yue.
It means moon.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look at the picture here, it's kind of look like the character itself. This is a moon, and this is something like eye.
Yes.
And this is the mouth. It's like cartoon, something to help you memorize this character.
Yue.
Yes, and we have a lot of strokes here, but easy ones. The first one is this one, 撇. Then
横折勾.
Then 横横. Two same strokes in the middle. 横横. So it's pretty easy, I think, if you can relate the character to this picture. This is the character, and everyone, please try to write something like this as we're explaining. I think it's pretty easy to follow the strokes here since you know it plays here, and we're also explaining the stroke sequences and strokes and the picture graphic things which help you to memorize it.
Please practice.
Yes, and
practice
then. Finally, we have something to say as sentences. For example, you can use to bargain or to buy something from a Chinese supermarket.
Yes.
Let's practice together. 您好吗?
我很好.
您想买什么?
我想买面条.
面条. 多少钱?
1万先令.
月饼多少钱?
月饼三万先令.
I think this one, the sentences here are very easy for you.
Yes, because and very short. Yeah.
Yes, most of them we actually already studied before.
Yeah.
您好吗? 我很好. 您想买什么?
Oh, okay, teacher, you are very fast.
Okay. 您想买什么?
你想买什么?
想 means want to.
Yes.
And 买 is buy. 您想买什么?
你想买什么?
You want to buy what?
What do you want to buy?
我想买面条.
我想买面条.
I want to buy noodles. 面条. 多少钱？
面条多少钱？
Noodles are how much？多少钱？Then 我想买面条。What if you want to buy something else, like mooncake?
我想买月饼。
Yes, that's correct. 我想买月饼。And 一万先令 10,000. 三万先令30,000.
Yes,
what 30, if it's 90,000?
九万先令。
Yes, 九万先令。
九，一二三四五六七八九。
Yes.
十。
十。Those are numbers we already studied. Hope you still remember it. So you can compose them with 百, 万, these number units as you like. You can make a lot more different kinds of numbers. Then...
All right, so we shall have a demonstration clip presented to you by Macquarie University Confucius Institute students. So let's have the clip and we'll be back shortly. Please don't leave.
你好吗？
我很好。
您想买什么？
我想买面条。面条多少钱？
一万先令。
月饼多少钱？
月饼三万先令。
老师，你想买什么？
我想买月饼。
月饼多少钱？
三万先令。
好的，谢谢。
你想买什么？
我也想买月饼。
你想买粽子吗？
啊，粽子，对，我现在换了，可以买。
Okay, 粽子 Chinese。
粽子，
Rice dumplings.
Yes, Chinese rice dumplings.
Okay, here are the sentences.
Yes.
We will review again. 您想买什么？
我想买面条。
Or 我想买
月饼。
我想买粽子。
All right. Please remember to follow us on our Facebook and Twitter page of Urban TV. That's where you can be able to see the questions. And the number to call is 0414-337-872. 0414-337-872. Please remember to call and keep away from your TV or reduce the volume in order for us to hear you clearly.All right, let's continue, teacher, as we wait for the callers.
Yes, we will have to say the questions again.
Yeah.
The first one, how do you say I want to buy mooncake? I want to buy mooncake.
I think it's fine. We can tell them and they can still, because we've been explaining it. 我想买月饼。
Yes, 我想买月饼。Or 我想买粽子。我想买面条。Any different kinds.
想买,想买。
Number two, how do you say 90,000?
Yes, how do you say 90,000? If 5 is 1, 50,000 is 1, how much is 90,000? Yes.
It's easy, right?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
The third one is how the character Yue was created.
How was the character Yue created?Please remember, the number to call is 0414-337-872. Want to hear your answers. How do you say, I want to buy mooncake?
Yes, and for the last question, how the character Yue was created. All of the characters we teach actually are pictographic.Those are easy for you to remember, for you to memorize. Same is this one, Yue. It's also pictographic. Please think about the image or the picture I just showed.
All right. Today we have a technical hiccup. So the questions will be posted on social media. And please remember, our social media pages are at...Urban TV and on Facebook still, Urban TV, both on Twitter and Facebook. These questions will be posted for you to be able to answer. Pardon us for today, we are unable to connect through the calls, but we shall have you on social media. Please, Ashraf, wherever your friends, please follow and answer the questions. That's how you can be able to answer them. And
yes, and I think we can also announce our Twitter accounts again,
yes,
so that we can get a lot of comments from you guys. Those comments, we expect those who can write characters on a piece of paper, and
yes,
maybe you can take a picture of it, and you leave your picture under our page, on our page, as comments, so we can see how you are doing with writing characters. Maybe
yes,
you can give some advice, and we can correct you if there is a mistake. And this is also a kind of encouragement for you to keep learning more.
Can you imagine that? That's very creative, teacher. The teacher has just given you an opportunity to write them on a piece of paper, take a picture with your phone, and then post that as a comment on our page. That way the teacher can be able to help you answer the questions, correct you where you're wrong. Amazing. That's good.
Yes.
Go out, Chen. And then I write, go out, Chen.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, Yue. I write, Yue. Mm-hmm. Very good. Okay. So,
so your account is?
At Namisi Moses Twitter, and then still the same, Namisi Moses Apollo on Facebook. Namisi Moses Apollo on Twitter, Namisi Moses Apollo on Facebook. That way we can be able to follow you. Yes?
Yes, mine is Wang Xiaojuan, both on Twitter and Facebook. You can easily find us, and we will expect your comments. We will post something,
yes,
so you can comment below, and we will give you feedback.
Yes, I shall help you. And remember, this show is brought to you by Confucius Institute at Macquarie University. If you want to learn more, please, you can join us at Macquarie University Confucius Institute. My name is Namisi Moses Apollo, brought to you by Wang Xiaojuan. We are your host on Urban TV, Let's Talk Chinese. And we'd like to wish you good night and have a wonderful week. Wish you a wonderful week tomorrow.